Someone asked me, like, should I throw out my black plastic spatula? And my answer to that is no, nail it on the wall. Have you ever wondered if plastics are harmful to your health? It's kind of hard not to with the kinds of news stories that we've seen about plastics getting into the environment throughout the globe, being found in all kinds of human tissues. There are lots of different ways that plastics can get into the environment. In the process of manufacturing, the nurdles, the little plastic nodules that are produced and then made into lots of different plastics, those can be released directly into the environment. Or once plastic products are made, sometimes they sit in the environment, like plastics that we use in agriculture or tires that we have on our cars, and those break down over time and can get into the ecosystem. Another source may be litter, so plastics that escape from our waste stream and get washed into waterways and broken down there. And then another, in many parts of the world, the main way of disposing of waste is by burning it. So burning plastics can get that into the air. So there's a lot of different ways that macroplastics, large plastics, can get into the environment and then break down once they're there and move from the water to the air to food systems to our bodies. Microplastics are any plastic particle that are less than 5 millimeters in size, and that's about the size of the tip of an eraser. We're also studying much smaller particles called nanoplastics that are small enough that they can pass into the human body and even into human cells. It's clear that the kinds of plastics that we've done research on in the past, usually very standard, smooth plastics that have been produced, often kind of large sizes, are not very realistic in terms of what our bodies are actually exposed to. The plastics that get into our body have usually spent a long time out there in the environment. So we're working hard to identify the kinds of plastics that actually get into our bodies, simulate those in the lab, and then use in experiments to get a sense of how different kinds of plastics of different shapes and sizes and concentrations with different additives in them affect the body. We have something here that we use to demonstrate this when we're talking to the public, call it a gravity bottle, and it's got 5 or 6 different sizes and types of plastics in it. And if you look at it, you can see some are light, some are dark, some are big, some are small, and they have different density. Even just in this little bottle here, you can see that they're all doing different things. And that's a way of giving people an idea that different kinds of plastic have different ways of moving through the environment and settling and eventually getting into the ecosystem and into animals and human bodies. One of the really cool resources that we have for studying microplastics here at the University of Rochester is McGrath Lab in Biomedical Engineering invented these silicon nanomembranes, and there's some here. You can see they're really tiny and the slits in them are even tinier. First of all, they're really, really thin, so you can put a large amount of water through them. Even if there are only small numbers of microplastics, you'll be able to capture them. Second, you can capture really tiny particles on them. And third, you can study them right on these membranes because they're made out of silicon. And that's super powerful. There's work on microplastics going on in so many different disciplines. And one of the beautiful things about working at a place like the University of Rochester is we're able to collaborate across really different disciplines and with our partners at RIT who have complementary expertise. And that's really the only way to address a problem that's this complicated. The Lake Ontario Microplastics Center, or LOMP as we call it, is one of 6 national centers on oceans and human health in a changing environment, which are spread out across the country. There are only 2 on Great Lakes looking at freshwater systems, and ours is the only one that's looking at microplastics. But what they all have in common is looking at this One Health perspective, really looking at both the environmental, the ecosystem, and then the human health effects of microplastics. And there are people who are trying to study microplastics in similar ways in different environments. Like we were working closely with researchers in the Southwest, where there are more concerns about microplastics that may be burned in people's backyards and get into the air and then be inhaled, or get into the foods that they're growing in their gardens and get into their bodies that way. And by looking at those 2 really different ecosystems in a holistic way, we hope to learn more realistically about all the different kinds of plastics that get into our bodies in different ways and the different effects that they may have on us. But it's way too early to know exactly what those health effects might be and how to avoid them. Someone asked me, like, should I throw out my black plastic spatula? And my answer to that is no, nail it on the wall. I think it's a great reminder of the fact that when you see a plastic, you don't know where it came from, what's in it, or how it was made. And we need to do a better job as a society of figuring that out so that you don't have to make that decision for yourself. The science of microplastics has been exploding. I love to show a graph of the number of studies on microplastics over the last 15 or 20 years. It's exponential. But I think that there are so many questions that what's really important is to pick the right ones. And my hope is that by studying plastics in this really integrated way with our partners at RIT and in collaboration with people at other universities across the country and across the globe, we're going to get to those right questions sooner. We need to do a good job of figuring out what kinds of plastics might be most harmful, what do we need to know about how they get into the body and what they do once they get there. That is going to be powerful and useful in figuring out how we can come up with solutions to protect people's health.